Now, we are solving the problems. Test the convergence of summation 1 by 2 power n plus 3 to the power of n. You see, to solve this problem, this is a series of positive terms or not. How you can say this is a series of positive terms means numerator what you have? 1. This is positive. Denominator what you have? 2 to the power of n plus 3 to the power of n. So, it is also a positive. So, entire term is a positive. So, this is a example of series of positive terms. So, first I am writing un is equal to 1 by 2 power n plus 3 power n, which is greater than 0. It is a series of positive terms. Now, we want to test the convergence. First, to test the convergence, what we will do means apply the limit. Limit n tends to infinity un we will apply. Limit n tends to infinity un you apply, what will happen? As n tends to infinity, denominator is what? Infinite. So, 1 by infinite becomes 0. Limit is here 0. So, it is convergent. If limit is not equal to 0, what we can say? Divergent. By what test? Necessary condition. Second one. You see, is it in summation r power n form directly? Suppose if it is only 1 by 2 power n, then that is 1 by 2 whole to the power of n geometric series form. But here you have 1 by 2 power n plus 3 power n. So, you cannot apply the geometric series test also. Next, we have third test, 1 by n to the power of p form. Is it like 1 by number power p only? No. So, you cannot apply the p series test also. Now, go for a limit comparison test. In the limit comparison test, first verify the un is what? Series of positive terms or not? Yes. Later, choose vn. Later, we have to choose vn. What is the vn means? Highest power nth term what you have in the numerator? 1. Is there any nth term directly? No. So, n power 0 is nothing but 1. In the denominator, you have two terms. One is 2 power n you have, another one is 3 to the power of n we have. So, what is the highest term here you have? 3 to the power of n. So, this is Vn. Now, test the convergence of this Vn. What is the Vn? It is in what form? Like, you see, is it the summation r power n form or not? Yes, this is in the form of summation r power n, where r is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is less than 1. Therefore, convergent by which method? Geometric series test. Geometric series test. Summation Vn is convergent. Summation Vn is convergent. Okay. Now, what we this is limit comparison test we are applying. So, second step here, limit n tends to infinity, un by Vn, you check it. Limit n tends to infinity. What is un we have? 1 by 2 power n, 3 to the power of n. What is Vn we have? Vn is 1 by 3 power n. So, you can write this is in the divided by 1 by 3 power n. Instead of that, you can write as 3 to the power of n by 1. Now, you have to apply the limit for this. If you are applying the limit, here you see, highest term you have 3 power n. Denominator is also contain this term only. So, take 3 to the power of n is a common and it will be getting cancelled. Then you have like a 3 power n common means 2 by 3 whole to the power of n plus 1. Numerator 3 power n, denominator 3 to the power of n getting cancelled. Now, you apply the limit n tends to infinity. If you are applied the limit n tends to infinity, you have 1 by 2 by 3 is less than 1 or greater than 1? Less than 1. So, as n tends to infinity, it goes to 0. 0 plus 1 becomes 1, which is not is equal to 0. Limit value is what? Not is equal to 0. Now, check the Vn is convergence or divergence. Since summation Vn is what? Convergent by geometric series test. Therefore, what you can say? Summation un is also convergent. By what test? Limit comparison test. Since summation vn is convergent and limit is also not is equal to 0. Therefore, summation un is also convergent by limit comparison test. Okay. Once again, I am repeating this problem. Test the convergence of summation 1 by 2 power n plus 3 power n. How to test the convergence even if you don't know? Starting, first of all, we have to apply the limit n tends to infinity un. If limit n tends to infinity un is equal to 0. See, if it is numerator, the series is containing numerator and denominator. If denominator is big, obviously as n tends to infinity, it goes to 0. In this case, by necessary condition, it may be convergence or divergent. If it is not is equal to 0, then you can say directly that is a divergent only. So, if it is 0 means, then you can go for test for convergence. We have a first basic test we have geometric series. Now here you see the given problem is not in the form of 1 by summation r power n. Like if it is only 2 power n is there, okay. Or 3 power n is there, okay. But here it is both 2 power n plus 3 power n. So it is not in summation r power n. So you cannot apply geometric series. Next, 1 by n to the power of p. Is it like n power 3 or else n power 2? No. So it is not in p series test also. So we have to go for limit comparison test in this case. First of all, we have to choose Vn. Vn, how you will choose means, in the numerator, write down the highest nth term. In the denominator is also highest nth term you write down. In the numerator, there is no nth term directly. So here n power 0 is nothing but 1 only. In the denominator, you have two terms. That is 2 to the power of n, 3 to the power of n. So what we have to do means here, highest nth term, what you have? 3 power n. So write down the 3 to the power of n. Now, this is in the form of summation r to the power of n. Where r is what here? This is, you can write 1 by 3 whole to the power of n. 1 by 3 whole to the power of n. So, r is equal to 1 by 3 less than 1. So, you can say summation vn is convergent by geometric series test. Now, convergent is over. What we have to do means apply the limit. Limit n tends to infinity, un by vn we have to verify, that is a non-zero limit you have to prove. And it is finite also, limit should be. Now, limit n tends to infinity, un I have written and vn also I have written. Un by vn if I written now in this case here, you have numerator 3 to the power of n, numerator 3 power n, denominator 2 power n plus 3 to the power of n we have. So, highest nth term here you have 3 power n, this is containing 3 to the power of n. So, 3 power n you take in the common, 3 power n you take common in both numerator and denominator. Then it will become 1 by 2 by 3 whole to the power of n plus 1. Now, as n tends to infinity, 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is less than 1. Therefore, it goes to 0. 1 plus 0 plus 1 is 1, which is non-zero limit. Yes. Since the summation vn is what? Convergent by geometric series test. Therefore, summation un is also convergent. But what test here? Limit comparison test. Okay.